the water cube with Dana, if I may say so. Dana, is that correct?
Dana,
sorry. Dana, could you please introduce yourself just shortly and what you're doing?
Yes, I'm Dana Krobler. I am a water resources management person, and I'm attending this conference to look at the links between water resources management, and cities, and the impacts of cities on water resources.
Okay, so that links up really nice with the theme this year, water and urbanization.
Yes, very much so. My career started off in water resources management, and now I'm busy to help local municipalities with asset management, to improve equipment, to improve quality that are discharged back into our water resources.
In South Africa?
In South Africa, yes, but we also conduct projects in Africa. So very much interested in the link between what local municipalities do, the human impact on water resources.
Okay, and is there something, if you go a little bit more in depth when it comes to local municipalities, what are the main issues right now that need to be tackled?
The main issues is asset management, the maintenance of equipment to ensure that drinking water quality is acceptable, and to ensure that the water that are discharged to rivers is acceptable and not doing damage to aquatic ecosystems. Mm-hmm. And very much the environmental water requirements that's necessary to keep aquatic ecosystems going to provide services to people is the key issue. And the focus in isolation on water resources is not doing the trick. So we got to look at what municipalities are doing to handle human discharges and human wastes, water facilities, to improve the quality of our water resources.
Okay. You've been around quite some time in the water sector, I assume?
Yes, I've been working for 22 years in the water sector, starting with pesticide analysis, metal analysis, all the way through chemical monitoring, and now where I am in local municipalities, helping local municipalities to improve the quality that they discharge to rivers.
If you could compare to when you started in this business and where we're now, what are some of the issues that have become more, which weren't apparent in those days? What are those now, right now? I mean, climate change is obviously one of them, but...
Yes, climate change is one of them, and also the lack of capacity to address some of these issues. And the complexity, the integrated nature of managing the impact of humans from a perspective of taking water, for using that water and discharging water, it became quite complex. Cities are becoming bigger and bigger, people flocking to cities for better opportunities, and the impacts in those cities are massive. In Cape Town, we need to import water from the catchment areas surrounding Cape Town to Cape Town, and basically sit with a lot of wastewater that we can discharge, but should rather be utilizing and reuse that wastewater.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for this short interview, and thank you for hosting us here in Cape Town.
Yeah, it's always our pleasure. You're always welcome in Cape Town.